been predestined according to the purpose of him who works all things according to the counsel of his will, so that we who were the first to hope in Christ might be to the praise of his glory. In him you also, when you heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation, and believed in him, were sealed with the promised Holy Spirit, who is the guarantee of our inheritance, until we acquire possession of it, to the praise of his glory.
Jesus restoring that mirror to the other. The arrest of Jesus, Peter's denial, the betrayal by Judas, the trial, the mocking, the scourging, and finally, the weight of the cross and the crucifixion. In this year's Lenten midweek services at Zion, we are looking behind these events that we have just listed to understand more fully the explanations of their meaning, explanations that come from God Himself here and there throughout the scriptures. Nestled in the exalted language of the Apostle Paul and his letter to the Ephesians that we heard a moment ago is one of those ever so powerful and significant words depicting the salvation that God has graciously wrought for fallen and sinful mankind, the crown of His creation, the word of which I speak that occurs in Paul's letter is the word redemption. Listen again to the seventh verse of that reading. In Him, that is, in our Lord Jesus Christ, we have redemption. Through His blood, the forgiveness of our trespasses, according to the riches of His grace, which He lavished upon us in all wisdom and insight, making known the mystery of His will, according to His purpose, which He set forth in Christ as a plan for the fullness of time, to unite all things in Him, things in heaven and things on earth. Exalted language indeed. These words, and the words that are related to it, are sprinkled throughout Scripture. Words like the word redemption. For example, Jesus says in Matthew chapter 20, the Son of Man came not to be served, but to serve, and to give His life a ransom for many. Mark's Gospel, chapter 10, records the same words. In the Old Testament, the Lord read, Moses, Exodus chapter 20, said that if a man's ox gores someone to death, that ox shall be put to death. Not only that, he goes on to say, but if the ox has done it before and the owner has been warned, both the ox and the owner shall be stoned. And then come these words, but if the owner pays a ransom that has been imposed on him, he shall give for the redemption of his life whatever has been imposed on him. This thought occurs over and over again throughout Holy Scripture. And it always means the same thing. Someone who is in debt, even if that debt should be his own life, is free from it by the payment of a ransom. Even slaves taken in war were free many times in the ancient world when they paid a ransom or when someone paid that ransom in their behalf. Suddenly a light goes on, doesn't it? That is exactly what our dear Lord Jesus has done for us. That is what was happening as His passion unfolded during Holy Week. Jesus' passion is not merely the heartbreaking story of a terrible injustice. Here is Christ laying down his life to redeem, to ransom, to purchase you from eternal damnation in hell. He is paying a ransom for the debt you owe. And what might that debt be? When Jesus told the Jews in John chapter 8 that the truth shall make you free, they retorted, "We are Abraham's seed and were never in bondage to anyone." That attitude is universal, dear friends. It infects our hearts also. The idea, much worse even than the coronavirus, Adam's sin has infected us all. That idea, I say, is a heart cell. Only the Holy Spirit of God employing his law can convict the conscience and convince a man that he stands guilty before God, even before he has done anything overt. He is guilty before God. That's why, again and again, we employ the words of Psalm 32, "I will confess my transgression unto the Lord, who forgave the iniquity of my sin." Moses spoke in Exodus, as we cited before. He wasn't merely talking about oxen and careless neighbors. He was giving you a glimpse of God's salvation. It was the same when Jesus spoke of the Son of Man being a ransom for many. And it was the same when the Apostle Paul used the word redemption in today's reading to speak of your salvation. You are ransomed, not with silver and gold, St. Peter writes, but with the precious blood of Christ. Like that